I win night, not feel
right. Time to spot some supercars. Oh, these are great. I should start recording these cars and putting them on YouTube. Sexy man Bud Bud has now changed to Supercars of London. Oh yeah. This is a good spot for supercars. Now time to transfer these clips onto my computer to edit. Let's hop into the Astra and head home. I've had a thought. It would be really cool owning a supercar one day. Being one of the people who have pictures taken of them. Perhaps a Lamborghini? Oh lord, I would die for a Murcielago though. I doubt that would ever happen though. Guess I'll just have to stick to my Astra.
The next day.
What the heck, my YouTube is blowing up with thousands of subscribers and millions of views. What a miracle. Imagine if I could buy a supercar from this. Ladies and gentlemen, I give to you my new V8 Audi R8 in manual. I never thought I'd be able to afford anything like this. It's a miracle. Why am I standing here talking? I want to drive this thing already. For 40 grand, I'd expect this car to be easier to drive. The steering on this thing is heavy. Okay, let's ignore the fact that this sounds like a V10. It's totally not a V10. This car is amazing, but it doesn't feel quite like my car. I feel I need to do a few mods on it to really make it mine. It seems a bit too tamed for a supercar. Right, I know exactly what to do to make it mine. Right, so here she is, all done up. First major difference you will notice are these new wheels. They give the car more presence and character, and I really like it. Second mod is a full F1 Armatrix exhaust system, a small mod that makes a huge difference. So enough of the jibber jabber, let's drive this beast through the roads of London. One thing I forgot to mention last time is that the turning circle on these cars are hideous. My Astra was so much better. Then again, I guess this car wasn't made to daily drive. I hope I didn't damage anything there. Ah, you can notice a big difference from this exhaust system already. Doesn't turn many heads when driving though. That's what a supercar is made for. It might be because of this boring silver that came standard on this car. Perhaps if I wrap this car, it'll grab a lot more attention. Oh my god, I love Iron Man. Imagine wrapping this car so it looks like Iron Man. Oh, I'd never do something like that though. It seems childish. But then again, childish stuff grabs a lot of attention. So I've wrapped my R8 and this is it. Not the most ideal weather to record in, but I had to do it. She is now dressed in Iron Man colors, because she's a man of steel. That makes no sense whatsoever. Whatever, let's just drive, and go on from there. Audi seriously have the coolest wipers ever, but the worst turning radius. And the heaviest steering. I can't complain, she's an amazing overall car. Oh, listen to that roar. I've never heard any supercar in London sound anything like that. She's one of a kind. Hang on, why am I driving a car with a red livery? I'm a Crip, not a Blood. Oh no, I really need to change the color of this car ASAP. Oh dear, where's Kit Customs? Ah, I finally arrived. I need this car blue. Here she is. The R8 is now wrapped in baby blue thanks to the awesome guys at Kit Customs. Hello woman, do you approve of my automobile? I think she's a Russian assassin robot. We need to get out of here ASAP. Oh look, a McLaren. Sorry, I need to depart. Cheeky slide. Rev limiter. Oh no, I triggered the speed camera. This color gets so much more attention. I should keep it baby blue. Oh no, but I'd want to change it for the Monaco road trip I'm doing later this year. Speaking of which, what color should I wrap it for then? Should I even wrap it? What about liquid dip? Oh my god, I have an idea for a color. This is going to be perfect.
The next day.
I've come back to this robot woman. So here's the finished creation. It has been liquid dipped in satin nardo gray, and you may even notice that it's gone back to the stock wheels. Of course, we are upping the Armatrix sponsorship all over the car to advertise the amazing company to the French Monaconese people. We've slapped a big GB sticker on the back too, because God save the Queen. Oh boy, I'm seriously looking forward to driving this beast through Monaco. So let's head over to France. It's dark here, but the roads are insane. Listen to that amazing Armatrix exhaust system doing its work. What a spectacular machine. I'm seriously loving these turns. Why can't England have these more often? I wish I lived in Monaco. The roads and cars here are amazing. But then would my channel name be changed to Supercars of Monaco? This is confusing. I feel my car isn't accepted here though. It's not exotic enough. I need an Italian car. I think it's time. I think it's time to finally get a Lamborghini. Right, the car has been reverted back to its original silver color. Time to head to Southern Sky Motors to sell this car. With the success of YouTube lately, I reckon I'll be able to afford a Gallardo if we can hit 2,000 likes. Ah, we have arrived. Time to sell this beast and get the Lambo.